Unless you've got your...
PeteTools.com.
G'day guys, how are we going today? Another beautiful day on my side of the planet. Once again guys, I wouldn't be dead for $1 million. Maybe 3 million, I might think about it. But $1 million, nah, I wouldn't even look at it. Almost summertime here again guys. And Pete's really, really looking forward to getting out and about again. Anyway, what's the old get on about today? What I want to talk to you today about, guys, is these plasma torches here. Now, all these torches are not created equal, and one of them is just bloody, bloody dangerous, and I'll tell you why. Anyway, guys, same as usual. If you like my videos, subscribe, drop me a like, drop me a comment, come say good day in the comments below, and let's get into it, eh? Now, guys, it's not really the torch itself. It's the way they've got the trigger set up. Now, if you notice on this one, this has a trigger on top of it, like that. See what happened there, guys? It gave me a fright. I did almost what I did the other day. This has a button on the top. This one here has a button on the top. Only difference is this torch here is connected to a pilot arc machine like this. And what makes it even worse, guys, is this machine here has its own inbuilt air compressor. So if you accidentally bump the switch, the thing will just start automatically. You don't get any chance at all of turning the bloody thing off. Whereas this torch here, guys, is also pilot arc, the same as this one. But the big difference with this is, it has a trigger guard on it like this. So you can't accidentally grab the thing and the thing starts going into your hand or whatever. Because I gave myself a first degree burn with this torch here. And I don't actually see how they can legally design a torch that doesn't have a bloody trigger guard on it. You might just say to yourself, oh, I wouldn't be stupid enough to do that. Well, Pete thought exactly the same thing. And I ended up in hospital and had to have my hand all bandaged up for a good couple of weeks. I tell you what, guys, if you get burnt with a plasma cutter, it's really, really not a good look. So if we turn this machine on again, guys, like I said, this has a built-in compressor as well. At least if you're using a separate compressor, it gives you like half a second before the thing will actually ignite. But this ignites straight away, guys. And it's about 5,000 degrees. And if you accidentally touch it and ignite it, like I did, what happened was I was working with this machine here. I had the torch on the bench like this, or somehow like that. I don't know how it was. You know how these things happen. Somehow or other, guys, I ended up with the torch looking like this, right? Now, I went to grab the thing just to do my final cut. I grabbed it like this. I just went to grab it like this. I'm not going to do it because the same thing happened again. I put my hand on it like that. Accidentally pushed it down with the weight of my hand. Ended up frying my hand right there. I mean, it's really, 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 really stupid, guys. And the only reason that happened was because of this bloody trigger here. So if you're using a torch like this, just really, really be careful, guys. But if you've got a PT31 torch like this, that's not pilot arc, it doesn't matter. Because if your machine's not pilot arc, you have to push the switch down and also touch it on the metal before the arc will start. So you can't possibly burn yourself unless you've got your... See that again, guys? That is really, really dangerous. See? Oh my god, I almost burnt myself right up the inside of my leg. You see what I'm saying? This is dangerous as crap, guys. So we can really easy change this torch out, my friends. Just undo the air lead here, undo the on off switch, undo the pilot arc wire. So we get rid of that. Now if we put the one with the trigger, so if we hook them up, put our pilot arc wire on like so, guys. Just like that. Pilot arc torch, same machine with the air compressor. Piece of cake. Now, can I switch that one on accidentally? Well, no. See that, guys? You just can't. There's no way in hell you can get that torch to start unless you specifically lift up the guard flap and then put your finger in it and pull the trigger. And you notice when I was holding that other one between my legs there, it gave me a fright and it started it here. You watch this. There's no way in hell that can turn on accidentally. I didn't even realize what I did when I held it there before. So there you go. Maybe I'm stupid, I don't know, but just be careful, guys. Anyway, guys, that was some more useless information that you really didn't need to know, did you? But forewarned is forearmed. Anyway, guys, same as usual, if you like my videos, subscribe, drop me a like, drop me a comment, come say good day in the comments below, and we'll see you next time, eh? Bye. PeteTools.com.